Okay, so earlier this week I posted a video about the QL in SOAS where it ended up us being inverted on the bar, opening the side up. Had a few people ask questions about inversion, what if I can't invert. And there are some legitimate reasons to not be inverted, but if you can be inverted and have access to it, it's probably something you should get around to and attempt. Dr. Ed Thomas talks about all the benefits of inversion in one of his articles titled Children of Play. So if you Google it, you can find it. It covers all the important benefits of that. So what do we do if we can't get inverted? What we're going to do, we're going to get down into half kneeling. We're going to get a jump stretch band. So for those of us in the Clydesdale division, we probably need a little bit heavier one so that we can actually get what we need. Lighter weight guys, gals can go with a smaller band and get the same benefit. But what we're looking for is to get some lateral flexion, some traction to this area. So what we're going to do, we're going to anchor our jump stretch band up above us. We're going to get our hand up in there to where we can get a little bit of traction from this position. And then all we're going to do from here, we're going to move away from the anchor point so we can kind of start to get a little bit of lateral flexion. But then we're going to let our hips lean away from that. And what we're trying to do is trying to laterally flex that spine as much as we can. We need to move around a little bit to get into a better position. That's fine. Important thing, we need to make sure that this down hip is driven forward so that we're getting that psoas involvement. We're not cheating around and in range of motion. And then the important thing once you get here, try and breathe as normally as possible. So after a week's worth of travel, this is actually not a comfortable position for me. And I'm kind of struggling now on camera with this. So probably should plan a little bit better. But why is that important? Why is breathing so important in this position? Well, if we remember back to our anatomy, psoas comes up and attaches into the posterior curve of the diaphragm. Well, if we're putting that psoas under stress, then that's also going to affect how the diaphragm is doing its job. Well, the job of the diaphragm is to facilitate inhalation. So if we're putting psoas under stress, that's going to also stress the diaphragm, which is going to make its job a little bit more difficult, breathing. So when we get into that position, if you lose your breath, or if it's hard to breathe, try to relax as much as possible. Really focus on that breathing until things are normalized with it. So if you can't get inverted, get a jump stretch band, give it a try. Let me know how it goes.